3 billion human lives ended on August 29, 1997. The survivors of the nuclear fire called the war Judgment Day. They lived only to face a new nightmare, the war against the machines. Skynet, the computer which controlled the machines, sent two Terminators back through time. Their mission, to destroy the leader of the human resistance. John Connor, my son. The first Terminator was programmed to strike at me in the year 1984. Before John was born, it failed. The second was set to strike at John himself, when he was still a child. As before, the resistance was able to send a lone warrior, a protector for John. It was just a question of which one of them would reach him first. Thank you.
I'm going to need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle.
You forgot to say please. Here, take 'em.
I can't let you take the man's wheels, son. Now get off or I'll put you down.
David to dispatch. There's been an electrical disturbance. Calling for backup immediately. Get here soon. Something seems up.
John, get in and clean that pigsty of yours. John? John!
Your foster parents are kind of jerks, huh?
I have had it with that gosh darn kid.
Hun, move.
Todd.
What?
That kid hasn't cleaned his room in a month.
All right, hang on. If it's such an emergency, I'll go do it now. John, your mother told you to clean up your room.
She's not my real mom, Todd.
Next patient is a 29-year-old female diagnosed with acute schizoaffective disorder. Usual indicators: depression, anxiety, violent acting out, delusions of persecution. And here we are.
Okay. Good morning, Dr. Silverman. How's the knee?
Fine, Sarah. She stabbed me in the kneecap with a screwdriver a few weeks ago. The delusional architecture is interesting. She believes a machine called the Terminator, which looks human, of course, was sent back through time to kill her. And also that the father of her child was a soldier sent to protect her. She was from the future, too. The year 2029, if I remember correctly. Let's move on, shall we?
Douglas, I don't like seeing the patients disturbing their rooms like this. See that she takes her storage unit, would you?
Yes, sir. Yes, officer?
Hi, are you the parent or guardian of John Connor?
What's he gotten himself into this time?
Oh, it's nothing. I just need to ask him a few questions. Is he home? No, he just went on his bike a couple hours ago. What do you need him for? Oh, I just need to know where he is.
Wait, there was a guy with him earlier. A big guy on a bike. Does he have anything to do with this?
No, I wouldn't worry about him.
Yo, where'd you learn this stuff?
My mom. Come on, come on, come on. Yes, yes, let's go. Yes!
Yo, is this your mom? She's pretty cool, huh?
No, she's a total loser. We used to do stuff together. But then she went complete psycho and blew up a computer factory. Now she's locked up in Pescadero. Come on, let's go spend some money.
It's like a giant strobe light burning right through my eyes. But somehow I can still see. Look, you know the dream's the same every night. Why do I have to explain
Please it? Please continue.
The children look like burnt paper. Black, not moving. Then the blast wave hits them and they fly apart like leaves.
Dreams about cataclysm at the end of the world are very common, Sarah.
It's not just a dream. It's real, you moron. I know the date it happens.
I'm sure it feels very real to you.
On August 29th, 1997, it's gonna feel pretty real to you, too. Anybody not wearing number 2 million sunblock is gonna have a real bad day, get it?
Relax, Sarah.
You think you're alive and safe, but you're already dead. Everybody, you, him, everybody, you're all dead! You're the one living in a dream, Silverman, not me! Because I know it happens! It happens!
I was afraid and confused. I feel much better now, clearer.
Yes, your attitude has been very positive lately.
It has helped me a lot to have a goal, something to look forward to.
And what is that?
You said I could be transferred to the minimum security wing and have visitors if I showed improvement in 6 months. Well, it's been 6 months, and I was looking forward to seeing my son.
I see. Let's go back to what you were saying about these Terminator machines. Now you don't think they exist?
They don't exist. I see that now.
But you've told me on many occasions about how you've crushed one in a hydraulic press.
If I had, there would have been some evidence. They would have found something at the factory.
I see. So you don't believe anymore that the company covered it up?
Mm-mm. I've shown a lot of improvement, haven't I?
You see, Sarah, here's the problem. I know how smart you are. And I think you're just telling me what I want to hear. I don't think you really believe what you've been telling me today.
You have to let me see my son. Please, it's very important. He's in danger. At least let me call him.
I'm afraid not. Not for a while. I don't see any choice but to recommend to the review board that you stay here another 6 months.
You son of a...
Model citizen.
Galleria?
Hi, have you seen this young man around here?
No, I've never seen him.
All right, thanks. Hi, have you seen this person, John Connor?
Yeah, I saw him go that way.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm gonna get us some more quarters.
Hey, do you know John Connor?
Nope, never seen him. Hey, John, I think this cop is scoping for you. Check it out. Nah, split, man. Just go. Hey, I think I saw that kid over there.
Thank you.
Jenna.
Okay, time out, time out. Stop the bike, stop the bike. Okay, don't take this the wrong way, but you are a Terminator, right?
Yes, the cyber dime system 101.
Whoa. Holy crud, you're real. I mean, whoa. Wait, so you're like robot on the inside, but alive on the outside, right?
I'm a cybernetic organism, living tissue over a metal endoskeleton.
Okay, get a grip, John. So what's the deal? I figured out you're not here to kill me. I figured out that part for myself. What's the deal?
My mission is to protect you.
Yeah? Who sent you?
You did. 30 years in the future, you sent me here as your protector.
Wow.
It is time.
This is intense. So this other guy, he's a Terminator too, right?
Not like me. From AT-1000, advanced prototype. Medic, Hollya. Liquid metal. The T-100 will not stop from you until it completes its mission ever.
So where are we going?
We have to leave the city immediately.
So can I
avoid the authorities?
So can I stop by home first?
Negative. the T-1000 will definitely try to acquire you there.
You sure?
I would.
What's that?
The following is an exchange recorded by the Vaught's home handset, presented as evidence in the case of the murder of Janelle and Todd Vaught, being investigated by the LA County Sheriff's Department. Janelle Vaught's time of death was pinpointed to before this conversation, so we're unsure who is pretending to be her in this call. It will be read as a transcript to provide clarity. For the purpose of this reading, the individual pretending to be Janelle will be identified as Janelle Vaught, or just Janelle. Janelle speaks. Hello? John then speaks. Janelle, it's me. Janelle speaks. John, where are you, honey? It's late. You should come home, dear. I'm making a casserole. After a pause, we can hear in the background Todd Vaught coming in and talking about John's dog, Max. He says, "What the heck's the gosh dang dog barking at?" And then yells, "Shut up, you mutt!" This is the moment of Todd Vaught's death by stabbing. Unclear how the imposter could have killed him, the blade was clearly far too long to be a kitchen knife. Janelle then speaks. John? John, are you okay? Here, an imitation of John's voice lies about the name of John's dog, who, as we said earlier, real name is Max. This is possibly to test Janelle's knowledge, as if John and whoever provided the imitation were suspicious it wasn't truly her. The imitator says, in John's voice, "I'm right here, I'm fine." After a pause, the voice says, "Hey Janelle, what's wrong with Wolfie? I can hear him barking. Is he okay?" Janelle responds, "Wolfie's fine, honey. Where are you?" The phone is hung up here. We have few theories, but we can only hope something will turn up in the evidence at the site.
I need a minute here. You're telling me that this thing can imitate anything it touches?
Anything that samples by physical contact.
Get it real! Like it could disguise itself as a pack of cigarettes?
No, only an object of equal size.
Then why doesn't it become a bomb or something to get me?
It can form complex machines. Guns and explosives have chemicals, moving parts. It doesn't work that way, but it can form solid metal shapes.
Like what?
Knives and stabbing weapons.
These were taken at Westland High Police Station in 1984. You were there. He killed 17 police officers that night. Recognize him? This one was taken by a Japanese tourist today. Miss Connor, you've been told that your son's missing. His foster parents have been murdered. And we know this guy's involved. Talk to us, don't you care? Ugh. We're wasting our time. Sorry, sir.
See, we spent a lot of time in Nicaragua and places like that. For a while there, she was with this crazy ex-green beret guy, running guns. Then there were some other guys. She'd check up with anybody she could learn from so she could teach me how to be this great military leader. Then she gets busted. It's like, sorry kid, your mom's a psycho, didn't you know? It's like, everything I've been brought up to believe is all made up bullshit.
Fantasy!
I hated her for that. But everything she said was true. She knew, and nobody believed her. Not even me. Listen, we gotta get her out of there.
Negative. The T-1000's highest probability for success now would be to copy Sarah Connor and wait for you to make contact with her.
Great! What happens to her?
Typically, the subject being copied is terminated. Crap!
Why didn't you tell me? We gotta go right now!
Negative. It is not a mission priority.
Hey, goddammit! What's your problem, goddammit? Help! Help!
This does not help our mission.
Get this psycho off of me! Help! Help! Let me go! Why the hell did you do that?
Because you told me to.
What? You have to do what I say, huh? Prove it. Stand on one foot. Cool. My own Terminator. Hey, you okay, kid? Take a hike, bozo. Screw you, you little bastard! Pew! No, you can't kill people!
Why?
No, you can't kill people! You just can't! Why? No! Okay, let's go get my mom. Just promise not to kill people anymore.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where I could find Sarah Connor in here? Wow, you're here late. Oh, here your friends come now. Where'd he go?
Hey Gwen, you want some coffee?
Oh, thanks. How about a beer?
Yeah, right. Oh, four of a kind.
Haha, yes, it is so great working in a mental hospital. Nothing ever goes wrong, haha. So, I was sad.
You broke my arm.
The blue stuff really is really bad.
Why are we stopped?
You guys promise you're not gonna kill anyone, right?
Okay, I won't kill anyone.
Swear it!
What?
Swear, say, I swear I won't kill anyone.
I swear I will not kill anyone.
Okay, let's go!
Hey, 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 hey. Visiting hours are 9 to 4. You can't be here.
Kaboom!
Oh, you kaboom!
What are you doing? What are you doing?
He will live.
my face!
Ba-dum-bum-ba-bum. Ba-dum-bum-ba-bum. Quick! She's locking the door! She's locking the door! Oh no, she's broken the key!
Get down.
Hello, my name is Bradley Harvin. Today I'll be presenting on my scene of how the good guys escape the hospital. Woo! Alright, now first you gotta know who are the good guys. Well, we got the T-800. He's right there. He's pretty cool. He's got that shotgun and everything. You got Sarah. She's there. And we got John. He's right there. Now, what's the point of a good guy if there's no bad guy? So we got the bad guy. He looks like that and that. And he also like morphs and stuff, but he's not human. He's a bad guy. Alright. And so, bad guy, he can morph and stuff, right? So his arms become like crowbars in this scene, and it's pretty cool. So, the scene starts with the gang of the good guys, and they're trying to escape this hospital place. So they're all in this car, it's a police car, and then all of a sudden, oh no, the bad guy has jumped on the back of the car using his crowbar arm things. So, the T-800, or Arnold Schwarzenegger, he turns around, he's got a shotgun, and he blasts that guy. And then that guy goes, oh no! And he falls off the car, and then they get out safely. And that's my presentation on how the good guys escape the hospital.
A ghost car blasts out of the darkness on a long stretch of moonlit highway. Headlights off, the hospital security car punches a hole in the wind. Inside the speeding car, the energy is still high. The air is blowing in the shattered windows as Terminator drives the car easily by electronic night vision. His eyes glow faintly red.
Can you see anything?
Terminator's point of view, a monochrome image of the highway lit bright as day. Terminator replies in a matter-of-fact tone.
Everything. Cool.
Sarah looks at Terminator, still not quite believing this is happening, but this is a different Sarah than the waitress of 1984. She spends only a second or two dealing with the unbelievable. Then she turns to John in the back seat.
You okay?
He nods. She reaches for John, and we think she's going to hug him. She starts to rub her hands over him, and we realize she's checking for injuries. Very clinically, the way a vet checks a dog for broken bones. He pulls away from her. He hates her always checking him, treating him like he might break, like some piece of rare china.
I said I was okay.
Sarah looks at him, exasperated and stern.
It was stupid of you to go there.
John stares at her, surprised.
Gosh darn it, John. You have to be smarter than that. You're too important. You can't risk yourself, not even for me. Do you understand? I can take care of myself. I was doing fine. Gosh, John, you almost got yourself killed.
We see his chin quiver. He's a tough kid, but all he really wants is for her to love him. He hasn't had enough years on the planet yet to be the man of steel she demands.
I had to get you out of that place. I'm sorry,
His face crumples. He starts to cry. Sarah gives him a cold stare.
Stop it. Right now. You can't cry, John. Other kids can afford to cry. You can't.
He's trying to be brave. He really is. Terminator turns and sees the water leaking from his eyes. It doesn't make any sense to him.
What is wrong with your eyes?
John turns away, ashamed. Sarah lets her breath out, realizing how keyed up she is. He turns to the Terminator, giving him a wary once-over.
So what's your story?
You all right?
Fine. Say, that's a nice bike.
You know what you're doing, right?
I have detailed files on the human anatomy.
I'll bet. Makes you a more efficient killer, right?
Correct.
Does it hurt when you get shot?
I sense injuries. The data will be called pain.
John, help me with the light. Do these heal up?
Yes.
Good. If you can't pass for human, you're not much good to us.
How long do you live for? Or, I mean, last for, or whatever.
I live 120 years with my existing battery.
Does your programming allow you to act more like a human and not such a dork?
I'm a learning machine. The more I be with humans, the more I learn.
Cool.
The machine breaks through the window and breaks open the fuse, not knowing what the boy knows. Through this brief exchange, the machine learns that humans are not all logical, and thus don't secure their keys. The machine informs the woman that they must get as far away from the crime scene as possible. The woman knows where to go. South.
Hey, do you want some of my fries? Need any help?
No.
You're dead. Am not. Are so. We're not gonna make it, are we? People, I mean.
It is in your nature to destroy yourselves.
Yeah, drag, huh? I need to know how Skynet got built. Who's responsible?
The man most directly responsible is Miles Bennett Dyson, Director of Special Projects at Cyberdyne Systems Corporation.
In 3 years, Cyberdyne will become the largest supplier of military computer systems. All stealth bombers are upgraded with Cyberdyne computers, becoming fully unmanned. Afterward, they fly with a perfect operational record. The Skynet funding bill is passed. The system goes online August 4th, 1997. Human decisions are removed from strategic defense. Skynet begins to learn at the geometric rate. It becomes self-aware at 2:14 a.m. Eastern Time, August 29th. In a panic, they try to pull the plug. And Skynet fights back. Yes, it launches its ICBMs against their targets in Russia.
Why attack Russia?
Because Skynet knows the Russian counterstrike will remove its enemies here.
Jesus.
How much do you know about Dyson?
I have detailed files.
I want to know everything. What he looks like, where he lives, everything.
Enrique, where are you? Oh my. It wasn't supposed to get shot. That doesn't actually happen in this scene. Enrique doesn't get shot. This is my bad. I'm doing this in one take. Oh, God. Okay. It's okay. I know how to fix this. Alright. He's just got one bullet shot. Alright. Alright, now I gotta turn on cheats. Go in here. I can heal him. Alright, there we go. Perfect. Good as new. It's like nothing happened. Here, have a drink. Enrique, I came here to get my stuff. I need food, clothes, and one of your trucks. What do I look like, some kind of charity to you? I need it now, Enrique. Give it to me. Oh, alright, you can have it. John, you're on weapons duty too.
At least my mom always comes prepared.
Excellent. This
is the only truck I got, but the motor's shot. Do you think you'll be able to fix it in time?
Yeah, but I'm gonna wait until after dark to cross the border.
Okay.
I grew up in a place like this. That's why I thought that people just run around in helicopters blowing things up. It's perfect for you.
You know, most of the guys that my mom got with were dorks. Some of them I liked, but they never stayed very long. I wish I could meet my real dad sometimes.
You will.
Yeah, but in like 45 years, I think. It's weird to think about that my mom and him, they only met like a day and she's still in love with him and stuff. I see her cry about him sometimes.
Why do you cry?
You know, because it hurts.
So it's a function of pain?
No, not really. It's sort of when everything's fine, but it still hurts, you know?
No.
Yo-ho! All right!
Watching John with the machine, it was suddenly so clear.
Here, here's how you do. That was good. Let's try again. Good.
The Terminator would never stop. It would never leave him. And it would never hurt him, never shout at him or get drunk and hit him, or say it was too busy to spend time with him. It would always be there. And it would die to protect him. Of all the would-be fathers who came and went over the years, this thing, this machine, was the only one who measured up.
How you do a thumbs up, alright? You just like make this up, go up, fist bump. Nice,
no problem.
High five.
In an insane world, it was the sanest choice.
No! Run! No!
South with him tonight like you planned. She will meet you tomorrow in
Mom! Wait!
Vroom! Whoosh! Vroom! Whoosh!
no faith. No faith in what we make. My father told her this. I mean, I made him memorize it up in the future. There's a message here. Never mind. Okay, the whole thing goes, the future is not set. There is no fate but what we make for ourselves.
She intends to change the future somehow.
I guess, yeah. Oh!
Dyson.
Yeah, it's gotta be. Miles Dyson. She's gonna blow him away. Come on, let's go.
I'm Sarah Connor, and I'm gonna go kill Dyson right now.
The plan is tactically dangerous. The T-1000 has the same information that I do.
I don't care. We have to save my mom.
But killing Dyson would theoretically stop the war before it even happened.
That doesn't matter. Don't you remember what I said about killing people?
Dyson's son was not ready to go to bed, but his mother felt differently. Dyson's son didn't care though. He continued to drive his toy car around the house. "Don't bother your father," she said. Dyson's son completely disregarded this and drove his car down the stairs to where his father was working. Wife and child re-entered the living room to console Dyson, but he was followed by Sarah. She proceeded to swear and yell at them until they got down on the ground with their hands in the air, while she stood over Dyson with her gun. Sarah, however, did not want to kill a man in front of his child. She quickly realized this and walked away and collapsed against the wall.
The Dysons is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
Shoot, we're late.
Do not worry, we're just fashionably late. Guess I'll open it myself.
Johnny, are you seeing what I'm seeing? There's no dessert.
Weren't you supposed to bring the pie?
Oh yeah, I ate it.
Wait, quit worrying about that. Mom is in trouble. John! Mom! Yo, what's up, Mom? Long time no see.
I couldn't. God, did you come here to stop me?
Of course I did. You're my mom.
Aww.
Aww. You make your mama so proud. I love you, John.
Aww.
I love you too, Mom. Now come on, bring it in.
Aww.
Come on, let's go.
Thanks, John.
It's a clean penetration, no internal nerve damage. AKA, you can just rub some dirt on it.
Thank you, Terminator.
Keep that band-aid on. It will terminate your boo-boo.
Okay, now that we got that out of the way, time to get the party started. Let's do icebreakers. Because I don't know any of you guys. What's the most embarrassing thing you've ever done? Nose goes! What is that? You touched your nose, so now you gotta go. Oh no, this is so embarrassing. But I guess I have to. Oh my god. Oh. Ah, check it out. Oh my god. But it does come in handy. Up top.
This is a reading from the Book of Cameron, the 137th chapter. King James Bible. Sarah puts out that Lady Fifth cigarette. The ladies sitting on the counter, John, Dyson, Teresa, and the Terminator, art at the kitchen table under a single overhead light. Dyson did listen while the Terminator did lay it all down. Skynet, Judgment Day, the history of things to cometh. 'Tis not every day thee findeth out that thou art responsible for 3 billion deaths. He tooketh to quite well, considering. After the Terminator finished speaking, Dyson saith, I feeleth like I'm going to throw it up. He looks round at those folk clutching at the table like he's about to blow hence. His visage, his posture, his ragged voice expressed soul-wrenching terror. This is a sir ripped out of ingrapped life into their grim. Thou art judging me on things I haven't co-equal done yet. Jesus, how wast we supposed to know it? Sarah speaks from the shadows behind those folk. Dyson turns to find that lady looking right at him. She said, right. How wast thee supposed to know it? Men, all thee knoweth how to doth is thrust into the ordinary with thy ideas and weapons. Didst thee know it yond every caliber in the ordinary is named after a sure? Colt, Browning, Smith, Thompson, Kalashnikov. All men. Men hath built the hydrogen bomb, not distaff. Men like thee be thought it up. Thou art so creative. Thee knoweth not what it is to like very much maketh something. To make it the life, to feeleth to growing inside thee. All thee knoweth how to make it is death, thee bastards. John said in reproach, Mother, mother, we needest to be as more constructive hither. I see not this is a gender-related issue. We still has to figure out how to stand, hold to all this from happening, right? Teresa replied, but I bethought, aren't we changing things? Iconically, but now, changing the way to goeth. Dyson seethes on yon. Yon's right. Hither's nay way I'm going to finish the new processor and on. Forget it. I'm quitting Cyberdyne tomorrow. I'll selleth real estate. I care not. We has to destroy the stuff in the lab, the files, the disk drive, and everything I has hither. Everything. I care not. Even the armeth and microchip. Sarah hath said in shock. What? I should have known, has the chip. The Terminator has said in reply, we might not now, but destroy all of T. Anon! This is the gospel of the Lord.
The future, always so clear to me, has become like a black highway at night. We were in uncharted territory now, making up history as we went along.
Gibbons, not again! Gibbons, you can't stop leaving the desk like this! Oh, crap! My card should work. Damn it! The codes must have been neutralized. All the codes, they're jammed. We're gonna have to abort. No, we can't abort. We are going all the way. But it's not working.
Don't worry, I've got this. You two can go ahead to the vault.
Calling all units. Calling all units. It's that man from the mall. It's the man from the mall. And that woman from the hospital. And the woman from the hospital. Get everyone here. Now!
Alright. I've got company access codes which should be able to get me into this door. Duh! It's not working.
Allow me to try mine.
John, fire in the hole! We're gonna have to wait for a while. We've got the halon system in here that's gonna make it impossible for us to breathe.
Take these.
All right, let's do this.
How do we set them off? Remote control. Piece of cake. We got company. Police? How many? All of them, I think. I'll take care of the police. But wait, you swore. Trust me.
Got good old Skynet now. Alright, Dyson, let's book it.
Alright, fellas, let's go!
Go, 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 go,
come on, come on, come on!
Go, 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 go,
let's go, let's go! Oh yeah, oh yeah! Oh boy, we're the SWAT team! Go, 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 go,
go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
ready to rock?
Ready. We have to go. Now. Take this. They're gonna use gas. Miles, hand me the detonator. Mom! Cheese, she's in the clean room. There's no way out of there. Get down.
Alright, kids. You're not gonna guess what comes next. As the SWAT team went deeper into the building, they found something that they didn't like. Dyson was holding a book over the detonator, and if he dropped that book, the building would go kablooey. So, as the Terminator, John, and Sarah escaped down the elevator, the SWAT team ran away because they were scared. And then, Dyson sacrificed himself for the fate of the world by dropping the book onto the detonator and blowing up the Cyberdyne building. That was pretty cool, right? Alright, what's next?
Shut your eyes. Stay here. I'll be back. Get down on the floor, face down! Down on the floor now! Okay, drop him!
Here, hold this.
Sarah, you know, this is pretty exciting if you were watching it right now.
Sarah's having an emotional moment with her son to make sure that she's protecting him. Oh boy. Sure hope these guys stay safe. I do love these characters. No, Senorita to Snuggleton. Get back here. I got you a treat. Take the treat. No, don't leave me. Oh, he's on the helicopter. He's on the helicopter. He's swooping down. He's swooping down to catch up with the Terminator and the friends. Oh, Sarah's got her machine gun, though. He's not going to stand a chance. Don't you mind me. Oh, she's shooting him. Oh, and he's shooting back. Oh, boy. What do you think of this Sullivan? Ah, shoot. He's shooting a lot. Oh, boy. Oh! Did they just fly a helicopter and be over there? That would be really cool if you were seeing this right now, let me tell you. Oh, boy. Wow. So many stunts. Oh, and he's shooting her from the helicopter, and she's trying to shoot him. Oh, boy. Oh, this is amazing. See, even the cat likes it. Oh, he's going up and down and up and down. This man must be a very, very skilled pilot. They just keep shooting back and forth at each other. He's got remarkably good aim for a man piloting a... Oh no, Sarah! Hey! Snuggle, stay here. Sarah! Oh boy! Helicopter just crashed into the car. Oh man. Oh wow. Well, it looks like the helicopter crashed, but... Oh! Oh, the police car, it toppled over on itself. Oh, no.
Hey, are you guys okay? Hey, that's my car!
Sorry, man. We got a blow.
Hey, man, what's going on?
So then, the good guy car is going really fast, and the good guy mom says, go faster! And they zoom into the lava factory, where they make the lava. The bad guy's giant evil ice cream truck slides into the lava factory and explodes. And the ice cream freezes the bad robot guy into an ice cube. And the good robot guy shoots him with a gun and says, looks like you're dead. And the bad guy breaks into tiny pieces.
And we're back. But first, a quick ad from our sponsor, Cyberdyne Systems, changing the world as we know it. Use code T800 at checkout for a discount on microprocessors so good you'd think the world was ending. Today we have with us John Connor here to talk about the next part of this harrowing tale. So, last episode we were discussing the time where the T800 was like, hasta la vista, baby. And shatter the T-1000 into little pieces. But of course, it's just not that simple. So,
John. What happens next?
All right, thank you for that great introduction, right? Okay, so I'll continue the story from where we finished. So I get out of the car, right? So, and my mom, she's there. She's making some, like, gasping noises. She's going, like, you know, because, like, she's a hurt really bad. But meanwhile, I'm walking over the T-800, and he's kind of struggling to get up and stuff.
But what about the T-1000?
Yeah, okay, I'm getting it. I'm gonna get to it. So the T-800, he's kind of doing like this, like it's not over kind of face, and I'm like, bro, it is over. He just shot this guy into like a million pieces. But like I'm looking at him, and he's looking at the T-1000, and like he reloads his gun, which is like, come on, guy, chill. But now like all the frozen, like because all the molten lava like spilled over the like frozen bits and stuff, and they're all like reheating. And okay, so this is where I was like, okay, bro. No, it's over. It can't happen. Like, he can't come back. You always said the cool catchphrase and stuff. Like, no, it's over. But, as soon as you know, all the T-1000 bits are coming back together, and it's stupid. Like, it's stupid ominous, too. And so now the T-800, he's realizing, okay, we gotta make, like, a baby and head out.
What?
you know, about, like, how babies head out. And, like, you know it. Okay, so he hits me with this, like, let's go, yeah, like that kind of face, like the yeah, and all of the while the T-1000 bits, like, they're more like liquid now, they're coagulating. Yeah, they're coagulating, right? And so they're forming up his head, and like he's rising up and stuff. And
Sarah, your mom, how's she doing?
Okay, she's not looking too great. Like no offense to her, like. It's kind of stressful, right? So, I mean, like, yeah, but, like, she's not looking too great because she's, like, all stressed out and stuff. And I'm like, come on, we gotta go. And she's, like, kind of slow because, like, she's, like, real tired out and stuff. And, like, I'm carrying her over. T-800, he's out there. He's getting his guns from the back of the truck. I lift my mom up, and now we look over to where the T-1000, he's doing his own thing. And, bro, he's coming out. He's coming out. He's rising out, like, liquid. Like if a zombie was, like, coming out of the dirt, but it was liquid, that's, like, T-1000 right now. And now, okay, get this. I don't know if you know what this is, but he's, like, making this, like this really wet, like, crazy, like, INTJ stare thing. You know what that is?
What? INT...
J stare, yeah. It's, like, this, like, super, like, uncomfortable, sardonic stare into the distance, but, like, kind of, like, at you, but, like...
Wait, hold on. Gaby, pull this up.
yeah, something like that, okay? So, anyway, the T-800 and I, we're walking back, we're dragging my mom out of there, and he's, like, looking at us, and I'm, like, all, like...
And that's all the time we have. See you next week, where we talk about the part where T-1000 starts walking towards them before the twist at the end.
Woo!
Okay, go! I'll take him.
So basically right now we have Sarah Connor and John Connor running through the magma factory, the metal factory, the steel mill, that's what it's called. So they're running through and then they get to this ladder, so they climb up the ladder, right? And so this whole time they're trying to like get away from this guy, the T-1000, who's also chasing after them, and he's going down these stairs, he's chasing them. And so they're trying to get away, and they're like trying to dodge all these obstacles and stuff, and then cut away to... the Terminator, everyone's favorite, the hero this story was named after. He has his arm stuck in a gear and he can't get it out, can't no matter what. So he grabs a piece of steel and shoves it into the gear and rips his arm out. Even though it's kind of like destroyed and stuff, he's free and he's out there to try and get revenge on the T-1000 and like mess everyone up. So now he's good. And so now we return to like the meat and potatoes of the story, if you will, with Sarah Connor and John Connor trying to evade the dreaded T-1000. And so they're running. And so at this, so John Connor, he goes through this chain and he goes up it and he goes down and whatever. And he arrives at a conveyor belt where he goes on it and he manages to evade the T-1000. Although Sarah Connor is not as lucky as John Connor, because she's still stuck on the platform with the T-1000 and now will have to protect herself. And we'll see how that goes in the next scene. Yeah.
Call to John.
No.
I know this hurts. Call to John now.
Suck on D's. John, I'm hurt. John, help. John, help me. Mom.
Get out of the way, John.
Shoot! Get down.
Ha ha ha!
Come on, you gotta get up.
I need to vacation.
Is it dead?
Terminated.
Will this melt in there?
Yes, throw it in there.
Adios!
And the chip.
It's over.
No, there is another chip. And it must be destroyed also.
No.
I'm sorry, John.
No. No, no! It'll be okay. Stay with us.
I have to go away, John.
Don't do it. Please, don't go.
It has to end here.
I order you not to go! I order you not to go! I order you not to go!
I know now why you cry, but it's something I could never do. Goodbye.
I look out into the future with a new sense of hope, because if a machine can learn the value of human life, maybe we can too.
Thank you.
Thank you.